Welcome back on Info 4EEE, and this is second video of Power Electronics using MATLAB Simlink. In this video, we'll discuss about the characteristics of thyristor using MATLAB Simlink, and you are with Paramjit Singh Jamwal. First of all, we will discuss the circuit diagram of thyristor during forward bias mode. In this mode, the anode of the thyristor is connected to the positive terminal of the battery, while cathode of the thyristor is connected through a resistance with negative terminal of the battery. In this, input voltage is varied from 0 to 10 volt. The variation of input voltage is shown in this row of the figure. For the variation from 0 to 4 volt in the input voltage, the circuit diagram will be this one. For this variation, we have applied a gate signal at 0 volt during the time period of this gate voltage. The input voltage is less than 0.8 volt, which is less than the threshold of thyristor voltage. So this gate signal will not be able to turn on the thyristor. So for this variation, this thyristor will remain off and will act as an open circuit. So there will be no current through the resistance. Correspondingly, there will be no voltage drop across this resistance, which is clearly shown here. So input voltage will be seen across the thyristor. So this input voltage, which is varying from 0 to 4 volt, will be seen across the thyristor here. For the variation from 4 volt to 10 volt, the circuit diagram will be this one. For this variation, we have applied gate signal twice. First one this and second one this. First of all, we were talking about this gate signal. At this gate signal, at 4 second, or you can say at 4 volt, the input voltage is greater than the threshold voltage. So this gate signal will turn on the thyristor, and this thyristor will behave like a battery of 0.8 volt. To identify the current through the resistance, we need to apply KVL in this circuit. We are not going to discuss the KVL in detail. For the KVL, you can refer our this video. So after applying KVL, you will get the expression for the IR. When input voltage is 4 volt, that means at this instant, IR will be 4 minus 0.8 upon 2, that is 1.6 ampere, which is clearly shown here. That is, IR is 1.6 ampere. And to calculate the voltage drop across this resistance, just multiply it by 2. So this voltage drop across the resistance will be 3.2 volt. When input voltage is 10 volt, that means at this instant, the IR will be 10 minus 0.8 upon 2, that is 4.6 ampere. So at this instant, IR will be 4.6 ampere. And the voltage drop across it will be 9.2 volt. So this is the characteristics for load current across the resistance R, and this is the characteristics for the load voltage across R. Now talking about this gate signal, you can clearly see that this gate signal does not have any effect on the thyristor voltage as well as output voltage or output current, because you can see here, even after some time we made the gate voltage zero, there is no effect on the thyristor voltage and output voltage or output current. So either you are putting the gate voltage zero or putting the gate voltage one, there is no effect on the thyristor. That means when the thyristor becomes on, the gate loses control from thyristor. So we can only turn on thyristor by gate signal, but we cannot turn off the thyristor by gate signal. So if you want to turn off the thyristor, you need a separate circuit, which is known as commutation circuit. We will talk about this circuit in another video. Now we will discuss the circuit diagram of thyristor during reverse bias mode. In this mode, the anode of the thyristor is connected to the negative terminal of the battery, while cathode of thyristor is connected through the resistance with positive terminal of the battery. In this mode, we are varying the input voltage from 0 to minus 10 volt. This variation is clearly shown here, 0 to minus 10 volt. For this variation, circuit diagram will be like this. In this mode, the input voltage is less than the threshold voltage for complete duration. So thyristor remains off for complete duration and acts as an open circuit. So there will be no current and no voltage drop across the resistance throughout the instant, which is clearly shown here. and all the input voltage will be seen across the thyristor. So thyristor voltage is similar to the input voltage. There will be no effect of the gate signal on the output voltage or thyristor voltage. Now moving towards the practical session on MATLAB. In this video, we are continuing the simulation we have created in our first lecture. So just open this simulation and save this simulation with different name, as we are going to draw the characteristics of thyristor using MATLAB Simlink. So just update its name and open Simlink library to identify the thyristor block in MATLAB Simlink. Again, go to Simscape as discussed in previous video, MATLAB technology and fundamental block, and that means power electronics. So here, this is your detailed thyristor. So just drag this block into your simulation file. Now remove this diode block from here and place this thyristor block here and connect its terminal. Gate terminal is given here at which you need to apply the gate signal. We will generate the gate signal through pulse generator. So just go to your Simlink library and go under sources and identify the pulse generator block which is here. Just drag this block into your simulation file and connect its output to the gate input of the thyristor at gate. Now to update the parameter of pulse generator block, just click on this block. There is no need to update the amplitude, it is already 1. Update the period to 4 and we will not update the pulse width. So just close this block by clicking on OK button. Now we need to update the measurement terminal of bus selector block. So just click on this block and here this is a question mark because we have removed the diode. So just remove this dummy terminal. And so first select thyristor voltage and second select thyristor current. Now our bus selector terminal has been updated. So just close it. In our presentation, we have considered first terminal for the gate signal. So just connect it with the output of pulse generator block. And second terminal was for the input voltage. And input voltage is at first terminal of DMUX block. So just remove this terminal and connect second terminal to the input voltage. And at third terminal, we get the thyristor voltage. So remove this terminal and connect third terminal with output of thyristor voltage. In our fourth terminal, we got the load voltage and load current. So we need to mux these two terminals. So just identify mux block and drag this block into your simulation file and connect output of the mux block here and connect first terminal with series RLC branch voltage, that is output voltage. So connect it here and second one thyristor current, that is also the resistance current. Now check the value of load resistance. In our presentation, we have talked about the resistance with 2 ohm. So just update this value and also check the parameter of ramp block. Here slope is minus 1. So just update it to 1 for the positive voltage variation. Now save this simulation and run this simulation. To observe the clear output, just click on scale S and Y axis limit here. You can see that we have got the desired result which we have discussed in our presentation. Now to check the characteristics during reverse bias, just update the slope to minus 1 and again run the simulation and also click on X and Y axis limit. You can clearly see that we have got the desired characteristics during reverse bias mode as discussed in the presentation. There is only one thing which is here, blue and yellow color, and basically this is a leakage current and which is very small. Here you can see that minus 4 into 10 raised to power minus 7, almost 0. So this is sufficient for today. I am thankful to Mr. Shiv Pratap for his appreciating word. If this video is useful to you, then like and share it. If you have any query or suggestion, then let me know through your comments. If you want to get the updates about our latest videos, then subscribe our channel and click on bell icon. Thank you for being with us.